Right, so the colours we're going to use are, we've got one from the colour range, we've got a pastel range and a shimmer. What?
Carambola.
What's a carambola?
No idea.
Shall I Google it?
Hey Siri. What's a carambola? Well, that was a waste of time.
We've got a periwinkle, which is a lilac, and lemon squash. Now, this is a shimmery one. So we have a look at this. It's a nice and shimmery lemon. So we're going to put the lilac, and I'm using this colour on this finger because I am going to put the... If you keep moving, did you see that?
Sorry. I did that without knowing I was doing it.
So I'm using this lilac because I'm going to put the daffodil on here. So I want like a contrasting colour. It's also complementary. And I love yellow and purple tones together. I think it looks beautiful. I had a dress once. Now I was very little. And
you're
we
still
were
very little.
Well, yeah, very young. And I was, where were we? We were on holiday. Was it in Wales or was it Blackpool? We were on holiday, and I remember having this dress on holiday. I don't even think it was bought from holiday. I think it was bought from Tammy Girl or somewhere like that. And it was lilac and lemon, and I absolutely adored this dress. You know, I have some clothes from my youth. I must have only been about... I have some clothes in my head.
Oh, in your head.
That are like fond memories that I remember wearing and really enjoyed wearing. I hope my children have that as well, you know, when they're older. I really do. So we're going to put the shimmery one on here. Yeah, and that dress I just absolutely loved it. And I think I was only about 7.
Got them colours on your t-shirt as well.
Oh my God, how weird is that?
Subconsciously
picked these colours. I had, do you know what I loved? Puffball skirts. I loved my puffball skirts. Did you have a puffball skirt?
No, I had a rah-rah.
Do you know what a puffball skirt is?
Yeah, is it the one where they've got the netting underneath?
It like goes like that.
Yeah.
Maybe we should bring them back in fashion.
Do you think?
Maybe not actually.
Yeah. Where did you get yours from? I think mine was from Vale Market or something.
Yeah, it was either Tammy Girl, Vale Market, or Wassey's Market. Yeah. So I'm gonna put the shimmery lemon colour, which is what's it called again?
Lemon squash.
Put that on the thumb. And I'm going to do 2 layers of each colour. That's our first coat. We're going to pop that in the lamp. I am going to top coat all of the nails before I move on to the artwork. I need a shiny surface to work on top of. A shiny surface with no tacky layer. That is essential.
What's going on?
What is wrong with you?
No.
Twitches.
I must have.
She just keeps like...
Keep touching it.
Just keep having a little touch and just cover me and gel. Pop that in the lamp, please. Right, so what we're going to do now is do these sort of... They're like a bubble rose, but they're not really a bubble rose. But it's using that kind of technique to create something that's very wearable, that gives depth. But we're going to use acrylic paints rather than we used gel polish. In the bubble rose designs. If you've not seen the bubble rose designs, I'm sure you can check them out somewhere there. Or they'll be linked below somewhere, wherever Adam puts them.
covered all bases there.
Yeah. So I am going to place it here. So I'm just going to buff ever so slightly because I'm going to go over this with some mega gloss. And I really want that to stick. So I'm just going to buff a little bit. And we're going to start off with one layer. Now, we're going to make this into... You love a bit of clear, don't you, Adam?
It's great to watch.
So I'm just using the brush to create kind of a circle. It's not a full circle. You want that to sort of settle so it goes smooth. That's what we're aiming for. Just tipping it up just so it slides down a little bit, so it levels out a little bit more. You can pop that in the lamp. I am going to now slightly buff because I'm going to paint onto it. You can do this kind of design with gel polishes. But I want to change things up a little bit and give you more options. It's all about the options. That's what we shout at football a lot. We go, options, options, give an option. Because if the player hasn't got anybody to pass to.
Can you shout, can we shout there at Stoke?
I can if you want. I'll shout, sit on the ball, sit on the ball. Don't do anything with the ball.
Just keep it.
Just keep it. And that's to the opposition.
Yeah.
What I'm going to do is with my colours, so some of it will be one stroked, some of it will be hand painted. I just want a slight fade. So we've got the yellow at the bottom and the white at the top, and you can see it's a subtle fade, and that's all I want at the moment. And all I'm creating here, it kind of looks like a love heart shape. I will go over that in a minute. And once that's dry, I'm going to move on to my next petal, which will be here. The hardest part of this is working out which layer to do first. The hardest thing about doing one stroke on camera is I have to move your hand everywhere and Adam will get slightly frustrated with me.
Yeah, I need six arms or I need another cameraman with me. Can you pre-warn me next time?
You can bring one with you.
I just need more cameras.
And we're going to go over the top of these now. And you can slightly neaten them up if you want to. So that one's more like a love heart shape. Whereas the other two are being viewed from a different angle, so they have a slightly different shape. Then with a detailing brush, I'm going to slightly sharpen up those edges, which will highlight it even more. And I'm going to pull some little lines through as well. Tiny, tiny. You can see those little lines. Just adds a little bit more detail. Don't be afraid to move your client where you want them. I'm going to take a little bit of green and just pull some little lines from the centre. And that'll actually add a little bit of shadow. Now, the next stage is to go over this with the Mega Gloss in that same circular shape. So if you do the outside first, then it'd be much easier to then fill in the centre. And you'll start to build up a little bit of height. Pop that in. I need to buff it to take away the shine.
We're always going to do a musical episode, weren't we?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Well, you could. You can sing, so why not?
Now we're going to work on the other petals. So they're going to be very similar to what we've just done. So we're going in between the previous petals. Very similar shapes, and you're overlapping. And you can see how it creates some depth because we're overlapping with gel in the middle as well. So you've got one layer of gel and you've got another layer of artwork, and it creates that depth. So I'm overlapping, giving it a second layer, it makes it stronger in colour. Gonna take a little bit of green, put that in the middle. Some people think, well, why are you putting that green there? Because you don't necessarily see it all, but you do see a little bit of it, don't you? So if you look here, we can see that green there, and we can see that green there, and what it's doing is adding depth. And we're going to do the same with the white as we did previously on the other petals. So just going around the edge and adding those little lines for detail. And we're going to mega gloss this now. Again, adding more depth, same shape. I am going to do two layers of mega gloss for this layer to make it even more higher. So again, I'm just going to buff. I'm only working in the center now, so I just need to buff that. So I'm going to come from here to here, and I'm going to use a tapping motion now, because on a, I was going to say dandelion, it's not a dandelion, it's a daffodil. And a daffodil, the edges of the daffodil are like frilly, I'd say.
Yeah, I suppose they are really, aren't they?
Yeah, so I want to create that by tapping rather than sweeping. I'm just going to go over that till I'm happy with the shape and I'm happy with the colour. Little bit of green, and that little bit. I'm just going to take pure white and onto the edges. Right, let's add up a little bit of yellow. Just here. Keeping the outside quite bright. Create those uneven edges. I'm just going to dot with the brush around the edge of this part of the. It's like a funnel kind of tube, like a tube thing, isn't it? What would you call that? There must be a real word for it.
Yeah,
what would you call it, Adam?
Don't know.
Yeah, just like a.
Tube thing.
Yeah,
tubular. Tubular thing.
Yeah.
Is that not an instrument?
No.
No.
I know what you're thinking of, but no. I can't think of the name.
No, I know. Oh, no, and I'm not Googling anything else today.
I Googled that one.
What's it called? It's called a...
tuba.
A tuba!
That's the one.
Yeah.
A tuba.
A tuba. Unless you're American, then it's a tuba.
Tuba.
Is it?
Yeah.
Did you ever play an instrument at school?
Me?
Yeah.
Recorder.
Recorder.
Everyone played the recorder until they couldn't.
Yeah, and then the xylophone.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, I don't know.
My recorder went missing, actually. I don't know if it was anything to do with my dad.
Oh, right.
So you were good then?
Yeah.
Did your dad slightly
yeah, he'd be like,
ban you?
Yeah.
Right. In the, does it have them things? It has them things. It has them things in the middle.
Yeah.
Sternum.
I don't know what they're called either. I don't know anything about
it's
flowers.
Something...
Stainum.
Yeah.
The thing in the middle that provides the pollen for the bees.
Yeah.
Don't really know what they're called, but...
It's similar to what you said.
Somebody comment down below. Why do I know so little about flowers, but like to paint them?
Should we get you a book?
Yeah, a book of flowers.
Mm.
Hey, have you seen that? You probably have seen it. Where you take a picture of it, it tells you what it is. Mm. That's fascinating me.
What?
Keenan took a picture of my mum's dog.
Yeah.
And it come up with a poodle, Bichon, all underneath.
Yeah.
You know, they're clever, aren't they, really?
What? How's that? How's that
I don't
happen?
Know how it works. Something on Google.
I know the thing does, like, if you're shopping, you can take a picture of something, it'll find you.
Yeah.
Is that the same thing?
Yeah.
Right, so we're going to go with Mega Gloss again.
So if you saw a flower and you took a picture of it, it'd tell you what flower it was.
That
it?
Is...
Oh, take a picture of this.
Yeah.
It'll say, I don't know how to recognise. No comprende. It's a yellow blob. So I've turned that upside down just so it draws down a little bit, so we get a little bit more magnification going along.